हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग ऑनलाइन। सो लेट अस डिस्कस गेट 2013 क्वेश्चन वन मार्क सेक्शन फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर प्रोसेस डेयरी एंड फूड इंजीनियरिंग। सो देर आर सिक्स क्वेश्चन इन दिस कैटेगरी। लेट अस क्विकली गो टू द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस सिक्स क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 20 to 25। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 20। देयर सेज मिल्क एंटर्स इन टू द हीटिंग सेक्शन ऑफ ए High temperature, short time pasteurization plant at a temperature of 45 degrees Celsius and deep set 72 degrees Celsius. Hot water at temperature of 95 degrees Celsius enters counter currently into the heat exchanger and leaves at 77 degrees Celsius. The effectiveness of the heat exchanger is 0.18, 0.36, 0.54, and 0.84. So heat effectiveness is the amount of heat expiry transfer divided by maximum possible heat transfer. And since this is a counter current heat exchanger, so the milk or cold fluid, that is this temperature at TCI, is entering at 45 degrees Celsius, and it is heated up to temperature of TCO, that is equal to 72 degrees Celsius. So since it is a STST pasteurizer, so and also the hot fluid is entering counter currently, and the inlet temperature is 95 degrees Celsius and outlet temperature is THO, that is 77 degrees Celsius. Now since it is a STST pasteurization actually, and it's a counter current heat exchanger, so therefore the cold fluid is minimum and hot fluid is maximum. So cold fluid, in this case milk, is minimum or minimal, you can say. So therefore the effectiveness is actual heat transport will be by the milk, and maximum heat can be exchanged between the maximum temperature minus minimum temperature. In this case, so you can write down like this: CC into T, that is CO minus TCI divided by CC into THI minus TCI. So actually this is the maximum heat could have been transported. This is the actual heat is transport. Therefore the effectiveness will be equal to CC is cancelled out. That is 72 is the outlet temperature of the milk, and inlet temperature is 45 degree divided by that is maximum inlet temperature is 95 minus 45, that will be equal to 0.54. so therefore the effectiveness of the STST pasteurization is 0.54. therefore the answer is 0.54. going to the next question, the equation representing the heat of respiration Q of fruits and vegetable as a function of temperature theta with positive constant A and B is Q A e to the power B theta, Q is equal to A e to the power minus B theta, Q is equal to A ln B theta, and Q is A plus B theta. So the correct answer will be Q is equal to A e to the power B theta. So this is a very simple respiration equation for fruits and vegetables. Therefore the answer will be Q is equal to A e to the power B theta. Next question, for initial spore load of equal to 25 spores per container inoculated with Clostridium botulinum having D121 is equal to 0.25 minute, the spoilage probability of the container subjected to F121 is 1.5 minute is 10 to the power minus 5, minus 6, minus 8, minus 8, and minus 9. So let us go to the solution. We know that the time of heating, or you can say we know that D is the decimal reduction time and T is the process time. So in this case the process time means F121, that means, and D121 means the reduction time at 120 degrees Celsius is given as 0.25 minute, and F121 is given, it is the process time, it is process time or T, you can say, it is given that 2.5 minute. So T is equal to D, we know that log 10 N0 by N. So in this case N0 is the initial number of spores for microbes, and n is the final number. And also n0 by n is called the probability of spoilage. So this is the reduction. So d is the decimal reduction. Therefore t is given as 2.5 should be equal to 0.25 log 10 and n0 by n. Here actually n0 is given, that is 25. It is of no use because we need to know n0 by n. So there is no need to put into this. So directly we can get n0 by n from this equation will be equal to that is 10 to the power minus 6. Therefore the answer will be 10 to the power minus 6. Next question, question number 23, slope and intercept of the BET equation relating AW by X into 1 minus AW and AW, where AW is the water activity and X is the moisture content on dry basis. That is given 18 and 2 respectively. The values of thermodynamic constant C and BET monolayer moisture content XM are respectively 40 and 20, 30 and 15, 20 and 10, and 10 and 5. So coming to the solution, so you can say the Raunert equation, so there is Raunert, Emmett and Taylor equation, the theory that aims to explain the physical adsorption of gas molecules on a solid surface and serves as the basis for an important analysis techniques for the measurement of specific surface area of the material. So in this case actually if you see the equation, we know the BET equation is like this, that is AW is water activity divided by X into 1 minus AW, that should be equal to 1 minus 1 divided by XM C plus C minus 1 divided by XM into C. So XM is it is given monolayer moisture content and C is the constant and X is the moisture content in the case, and AW is the water activity. So in this case one is the intercept, this is the intercept, and this is the this one, sorry, AW is there, so this one is the slope. So I and slope is given, so I is given 2 and slope is given 10 in this, sorry, 18. So since the slope is 18, so we can directly take from this equation, that is we can say 1y, so 1y xm into c, that is equal to 2. So from there you can say xm into c, that is half. So putting this into this equation, you can say c minus 1 divided xm c, that is the slope, that is given 18. Therefore putting the xm c minus 1 divided half is equal to 18. Therefore c minus 1 is 9 and c can be calculated as 10. So c value or from this equation is 10, and putting this c into this equation, that is 1 by xm into c is 2. So instead of c you can put xm, so xm will be equal to 1 by 2 into c. Instead of c you can put 10, so that will be 1 by 20. So 1 by 20 value will be equal to 0.05 is equal, that is in fraction, so we can calculate as 5% is the moisture content, or is monolayer moisture content is 5% and c is 10. So it is asked the value will be 10 and 5 the answer. Therefore the answer will be D, that is 10 and 5. Next question, question number 24. It says a cold storage chamber is constructed with 10 mm mortar, 200 mm brick, 100 mm insulation and 5 mm wood having thermal conductivity of 0.8, 1.5, 0.205 and 0.2 watt per meter per Kelvin respectively. The resistance of 4 km per meter square per watt is offered by mortar brick insulation. It's a very simple one. Here actually you, the thermal resistivity is given, there is 4, and conductivity and thickness is given. So for each individual, you just calculate which one is 4, then it, that will be the answer. First of all, the resistivity will be equal to the thickness divided by conductivity. So in this case, let us say x is the, for each first one is the first one is 10 divided by it is given 0.08. There is not 4. So second one is 200 divided by 1.5. That is also not equal to 4. So there is not 10 actually. There is 0.01 and this 0.2. Because this is given in millimeter, it should be in meter. So it's not 4. The third one, the insulation, for insulation, there is 100 millimeter, there is 0.1 divided by the thermal conductivity K is 0.025, which is equal to 4. So this should be the answer. But again, you can check the last one, there is the thickness is given 0.05 or 5 millimeter divided by that is 0.2. So which is actually not 4. So therefore the answer will be insulation. Insulation 1, that is R for insulation is 4. So this is the answer. Next question is question number 25. The horsepower of the motor running the compressor of a refrigerator having COP of 4.5 and extracting 200 kilojoule per kg of evaporating heat with 1.5 kg per minute refrigerant flow rate is 0.5, 1, 1.5 and 2. So it's a very simple actually. If you see the evaporator has a heat, that is the extracting the heat, QE you can say, from the evaporator, that is equal to the fluid is having the rate, that means the extracting the heat is 200 kilojoule per kg, and also the fluid is means you can say that is flow rate of the fluid. So that is given is how much QE to multiply with the flow rate, because this is the extracting rate, and this if you multiply with the 1.5 kg per minute, so this will be QE. QE is the heat extracted. So if you say kilojoule kg per kg, if you then it will be 200 into 1.5 kilojoule per minute. So to make it kilojoule per second, so divide by 60, so that will be equal to kilojoule per second, that is kilowatt. So that means the heat extracted from the evaporator will be 5 kilowatt. So 200 into 1.5 divided by 60, that is 5 kilowatt. 5 kilowatt is the QE. Now we can just convert it to HP because it is asked in HP. So 5 divided by you can say 0.746, that is equal to 6.7 HP. 6.7 HP is the QE. And also we know that work done by the compressor, let it WC, that is equal to QE divided by COP. So once we know the QE or extraction of heat from the evaporator, then that will be 6.7 divided by COP is given. In this case, COP is given how much? That is 4.5. So there is 6.7 divided by 4.5 will be equal to 1.48 HP. So which is equivalent to 1.5 HP. So the answer in this case is C, which is given 1.5 HP. So hope you understand all the questions. Please like and subscribe to my channel, Agriculture Online.